I think I got it, but could you just run it by me one more time?
All right, it's really simple, right? We've got this bit of dirt, right? We've got the shovel. We just shove the shovel into the dirt. We dig it up a little bit, dig it a little bit further, and a bit more, and a bit more. And Bob's your uncle. We got a hole. Anyway, what are we doing?
We're doing the podcast, actually the official Team DBAH Podcast number 161. Come join us, why don't you? Hello and welcome to the official Team DBAH podcast number 161. I'm Charlie Danger 82, and with us tonight we have Craig.
Hello.
We have James Griever 2112, not only a man but a Rush album and owner of the Griever 2112 on YouTube.
Hey, what's up?
He sounds so different tonight. I think it might be. I think it's Dave wearing a James suit, but I'm not entirely sure.
Okay, that just went really creepy really quick.
Keeping my eye on you. And speaking of Dave wearing a James suit, we also have Jamie.
I am not Dave.
You are not Dave. You're Jamie.
Hello.
Hi. So, I had an entire dissertation for tonight. I was going to decry pre-ordering things and have a huge soapbox to stand on, and it was going to be awesome, and there was going to be fireworks and brimstone and everything, but it would appear that my plans were thwarted because Modern Warfare Remasters does work without the disc. I'm sorry, I hate to announce it, but we won't be going to GameStop with any pitchforks or torches. You win this time, GameStop.
I thought it needed the disc.
Apparently it did. A lot of articles came out saying that Modern Warfare Remastered won't work without the disc. And of course, this was after I paid it off because we got that promotion last week saying if you pre-ordered Modern Warfare, or if you pre-ordered Infinite Warfare Legacy Edition on the PS4, you'll get the whole campaign 30 days earlier on the PS4. So I'm like, cool. And then I heard, it won't work without the disc. And I'm like, well, how are you going to do that, Mata Hari? And I was getting ready. I was getting ready. Just like I started down, because last night I got a code in the email, which shocked and amazed me, because when I ordered the Taken King. Yeah, you're telling me. When I pre-ordered the Rise of Iron, I had to go into the store physically, even though it was a digital download, so I could get the codes that they gave me that I could use, which didn't even turn out to be Rise of Iron. It turned out to be a gift card for $32 on the Microsoft store. And So I get this email saying, here's your code for Modern Warfare Remastered. And I'm like, oh, well, that's cool. And so I plug it in. I'm like, oh, when this doesn't work tomorrow, I'm going to do it. I'm going to go right down there to GameStop. I'm going to cancel all my reserves. Oh, this is going to be incredible. I'm just going to say, you know, I love you guys that work here, but fuck your company because you guys are assholes. And then, lo and behold, this morning, my plans were thwarted. Before I could even put my contacts in when I turned it on and it worked. Multiplayer does not work. Might be multiplayer that only works with the disc. But who knows? Oh, also I have to say from time to time tonight, we will have another guest because Randall is also here.
Yeah, you remembered me.
Of course I did.
I guess I'm allowed to join.
Hey, Kimmy, how could I forget you? I had a weird moment before the podcast started because I could hear my cousin on Randall's through Randall's Xbox, and I thought he was like watching a video that I had done because our voices are very similar, like, over like audio. So I was like, oh, that's so nice. Randall's watching my videos. And then I heard, like, fucking do a Call of Duty over here. I'm like, oh, no, wait, that's my cousin. So, so yes, put the embargo, the revolution, the resistance is quelled for now. I'm sorry, guys.
You were so looking forward last night to just it not working and, like, losing your shit today.
I made a banner. Okay? I'm just... Ooh. Yeah, you're telling me. However, something weird is going on right now. Craig and I have discovered something.
Oh, yeah, huh?
This was discovered, like, probably about 15 minutes before the podcast started, too. Craig, what product did you buy?
I digitally ordered the digital version of Gears of War 4.
Right.
and a demo of ReCore.
And this is one of the two, those two titles are two of those Play Anywhere titles. That's very important.
Yes.
Well, when I go on vacation, I don't take my bastard child with me. I leave the Xbox One at home, and I let Craig use it for when I'm on vacation. So, because he doesn't have a Xbox One, I load it up with the exclusives, and I say, here, have fun. And he had his profile on there. Well, last week, and you guys know this, you guys were there, when I had to reset everything on my Xbox, it's been documented. My profile was the only one left on this machine, but I turned it on tonight because I wanted something to look at to make me angry in the background of the podcast. And I turned it on, and all of a sudden it's given me this message saying, you know, could not download Gears of War 4 because your shitty hard drive is all filled up, man. You should start deleting something. I'm like, I have like 40 gigs free. And then I look at it and it's like Gears of War 4. 54 gigs on my machine. I'm like, huh, this is interesting. Now, I did not know that Craig had ordered this. So I think I'm downloading his Xbox version while he's downloading his Windows version. So who knows? I might be canceling a reserve at GameStop.
We'll find out.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Well, if so, that's probably the best stroke of luck you've ever had with the Xbox at that point, then.
You shitting me? This is... I call the Xbox the Give Me a Reason one. I just, it's like, whenever I look at it, I scowl at it. But anyway.
Do you have Kinect plugged in?
I do not. I don't believe in the Eye of Sauron.
That is good, because otherwise all it would see is your angry face, and it would get sad.
All the time. It's great because I just started, you know, I threatened it for such a long time. I started finally playing Dark Dreams Don't Die, where, you know, your dying wife tells you to look for D. I'm finally looking for D on my Xbox, and it has Kinect controls and it has controller controls. I'm so glad I have it on controller, because if I had to gesticulate the way that it's supposed to on this, I'm like, I'd feel a bit silly. So, but enough about me. Jamie, how you doing, man? What are you playing? What are you doing? What are you watching? Tell me about your life.
Well, I've got a few stories. Actually, I don't
all right. Know. Okay, you don't. Good.
My life has been Destiny again. Which is...
Yeah?
Yeah. It's actually funny, Griever. You was telling me a story a little while ago.
Mm-hmm.
About how you were using me as an example about why Dave should download Rise of Iron.
Yeah, me and Dave were talking Monday, and I was like, well, you know, Jamie got Rise of Iron, so, you know, when are you going to get it? And then he informed me of something, but...
And David's just like, yeah, Jamie hates it.
Yeah. And then I was just like, damn.
I think my first reaction upon downloading Rise of Iron is I went in and I joined Charlie and George and I just sighed.
Well, that was also, you were terribly underleveled, and when you joined up on us, we were right in the middle of Archon's Forge.
Oh yeah, I couldn't kill anything.
So, you can shoot the stationary things real good, but
I was just running around. It was fun.
But, like, you found stuff that I didn't even know. You were showing me, like, SIVA clusters and everything, and you were showing me around the chalet once it had opened its doors. You showed me the secret of just waiting around till someone pops that certain rune and then floating up to get that hidden SIVA cluster on top. Yeah. You showed me that trick. So, there was that. I mean, it's...
Yeah, I kind of did like all the collectible little bits because they're kind of the bits of games I kind of enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
So I've done the clusters that I need to get for the book, and I'm like doing specific book stuff just because.
The book stuff is fun. I enjoy the book stuff, mm-hmm. and
it's fancy. I'm doing as much of the game as possible before I will eventually be done with the game.
Well, we all have to team up so we can do the bell thing.
The bell thing is going to be the bane of my existence until the bells ring.
Yeah.
I think I told you the other day that I spend time just sitting by the bells hoping someone will do it for me.
Yeah. Oh, man.
What I do wish someone could climb the mountain for me.
You got to the top of the mountain, though, right?
I did. I collected a little red thing, stood by a nice fire, and then killed myself.
Sounds about right.
Now, did you kill yourself because you jumped off the mountain, or did you kill yourself because you had just spent 3 hours trying to scale a mountain in a video game?
Oh, my Xbox wasn't on at that point. I just killed myself.
Wow.
I'm like a cat. I've got more lives.
Oh, wow. Sheesh.
And now, Destiny's decided to hate me more by, this week being the Iron Banner, and that being part of the damn book. Because I do love Crucible.
The two other people that I play Destiny with, they were not having a good time last night, as much fun as I was having in the Crucible last night. During Iron Banner.
I fucking hate Supremacy. I've learned.
Though I did get to rank 5 today, 2 days. Only took 2 days.
You got to rank 5?
Yeah. And all I got was a machine gun.
Hey Randall, do you want to play? You want to play Iron Banner after this?
Possibly.
Because I'd like to play the Iron Banner after this. But, you see, I absolutely love Supremacy. But George and James do not like Supremacy at all.
Supremacy was fun at the beginning. But when you get... Okay, see, here's the problem. See, the one good thing with the Iron Banner is it brings everyone together in Crucible to, come together and just, play against each other in whatever game type it is and all, whatever. But the problem with Supremacy is, and the morons that we're getting teamed up with, is it's like playing Overwatch. Play the fucking objective. You will see people just going for kills, not picking up crests, not picking up the crest that drop when you die.
Yep.
And then the other team all of a sudden has a 30-point lead, and it's like, wait, we just killed 15 of them. How did that happen? Oh, wait, those idiots didn't pick up the friggin' crests. That's why I hated Supremacy.
Nor did they deny crests, which is a big part of it as well.
Yeah.
I deny whenever I can.
I'd rather deny than to go pick up something because
absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. But see, absolutely. See, Charlie, the thing is though, we play the objective. Those morons we were playing with last night did not.
Well, to those morons' credit,
we had one good game, and then what the fuck happened?
To those morons' credit, we also got yelled at the halftime point when we were told we have to focus on killing people as opposed to picking up the crests. So maybe someone else on the team mentioned something like that. And I said, but that's not how you play the game.
All right, here's the secret to this game type. Get a scout rifle, get a shotgun.
Yeah.
Sit back as far as you can, shoot people with scout rifle. If you see someone come up on your radar, it's close, pull out that shotgun and shoot that mother flipper in the chest.
Oh, shit, son.
Yeah. But, scout rifles from far distance is really good because everybody's focused on shotgunning and picking up crests. So if you're far back with a scout rifle, it's proven to work very well.
See,
unless you've got
really something.
Good machine gun. Or not machine gun, auto rifle.
Well, the thing is, something horrible happened to me. I on a drop, I got the unbent tree branch or whatever the fuck it's called.
Ooh,
and,
tree blaster.
It has, like, the fire rate of Atheon's epilogue. So, I even though, like, it.
Stick?
Yes, but the thing of it is, I used to use Atheon's epilogue until I bought the Suros regime. That was my favorite gun. So when I got this weird ass looking thing with a bayonet that looks like it would do more damage to me than my opponent, because it's pointed at me, I just fired it to test it out. And when like 30 bullets flew out, I'm like, this is my new favorite gun. But it's not very effective. I don't care. This is my new favorite gun. You won't kill anything with it. This is my new favorite gun.
Yeah, it's that the fire rate is the quote unquote doctrine of passage style one, where it's got like a maxed out rate of fire, but like absolutely nothing in impact. So
I'm always running and I'm always running up on people. So I'm close enough.
That's the thing. A lot of people do like that type of auto rifle because it just, for them, for their playstyle, it just works. So, I mean, if it works for you, it works for you. I'm not saying anything about it. I don't like them because it doesn't work for me.
And I just got my invective. That dropped for me. So. But the other thing is, I spent $25 on getting fire all over me. And
silver.
And then the raid gear dropped that was better than what I was wearing. So I'm going to get a full set of like jacked up raid gear and then I'll infuse it. But for now I'm just like, I hate this fucking game so much. I paid for self immolation and it just didn't. But you were saying, Jamie.
Yeah. The only strategy that I see people do that seems to work is you run, you slide on the floor with a shotgun, and you're basically a tank. They basically transform into a tank, hit you, you're dead, and then they run off.
Like Bastion.
But I want to know what these guardians cover their armor in. Because people slide like
fast food grease.
Like fast food grease or Crisco.
It's basically they run and then pull out a toboggan and then just come pile it out. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey. They'll do that. It's like that scene from The Transporter. They grease themselves up and they just slide around.
I'm just picturing the one scene. Do you guys remember the movie Major League?
Yeah.
I'm remembering that point when Rick Vaughn notices this shit on the older pitcher's chest and goes, "What is that shit on your chest?" He goes, "Crisco, Bardol, Vegisil. Any one of them will give you another 2-3 inches on your slide and drop."
That's right.
Damn guardians.
Fuck you, Jobu. I do it myself.
Can I also say
Callahan comes and whacks him in the head.
Can I also say right now the announcer for Crucible sucks?
How do you feel?
He has no emotion. He's just a... It's like a guy who's been locked in a cage for 4 years and then they suddenly gave him a script.
But he's always like that, though. It wiles me that they told us that Peter Dinklage wasn't being a good robot, and yet they let this guy, who's not being a good whatever, stay.
Yeah, they kick out
Peter
Dinklage.
Guardian.
And a well-known actor Guardian. From a well-known TV show, and then they keep this bored homeless guy.
Their dignity is in your hands.
Like, and sometimes he doesn't even speak good grammar. He says, yeah. Enemy team almost won. Winning
you
soon.
You should go talk to Lord Shax.
Yeah, go train him out.
Is that who he is?
Did they replace Nathan? Oh,
no, they didn't. He's still there. He sounds like R2-D2.
They just didn't give any lines this year.
Oh, they gave him a ton of lines.
Did they?
Like, in Archon's Forge, he actually quoted Varric. Like, after a match was done in Archon's Forge, I actually heard Nolan North say, "They are dead. You are not." That's humorous.
I thought we were talking about Fillion.
Oh, no. No, oh, yeah. Wait. Is that who you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
None of the Vanguard have any new lines in this.
Oh, no. Yeah, the Vanguard don't have new lines, but... Oh, I thought you were talking about Nathan Drake.
Oh, no. Different Nathan.
No, he's just not in the story. Shiro 4 is now our new Cage 6. So...
The first time I heard that guy, it sounded very similar. And I got sad when I found out it wasn't him.
Well, another thing that I told James and George the other night, Lord Saladin is actually a very familiar voice actor to everyone in this group. I mean, you might not recognize him at first, but you could recognize him by his other voice line. "I'm not a psychopath. I'm a high-functioning psychopath." Because he plays Reaper in Overwatch.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Like that's that scene where he just jumps down from the ship and he starts shooting at the things. You can actually hear a little tiny, if you listen closely, he's like, "Die, die, 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 die." So it's like very, very, very faint, but you can hear it.
I still enjoy that video you sent me.
Which one?
With Reaper sitting, like, having lunch with people, and they do their different specials against him.
Yeah, that it's a... Oh, God, I forget what the channel was, but it's just, like, people's... just Overwatch people's specials, and it's a dude just dressing up in different costumes and doing different moves, and when it was Genji and Hanzo, he just takes a pool noodle and hits the guy in the face with it. And I think he just, like, rolls over him as he's hitting him with a pool noodle.
It's called how Overwatch characters eat their food.
Yes! Thank you.
I think that's a whole series. I think he does that for a load of different things. I think I've seen, like, how animals eat their food or something.
Yes, the animals eat their food is hilarious. I saw Rhett and Link were in that one also from Good Mythical Morning.
Yeah. It's such a funny series because you watch it and it's, like, all low budget. Like, there's just people, like, in their shoes and socks, and they're just, like, "I've got a cardboard box." And then they have those little moments where they, like, got really, like, good costumes or... So it's got, like, a weird balance. And they put effort into it, but the right kind of effort where it doesn't look like they're trying too hard.
Yeah, the channel is called MrEpicMann. Man with two N's at the end.
There's a plug for them.
Very cool. Yeah, definitely. Hey, MrEpicMann, if you want to be on the podcast, please. We're more than happy to have you on the podcast.
Well, you know, if you want to do a new show, how Team DBAH eats food. Dave just complains about it.
J- Jamie has his with tea.
I just have tea. I just knock it on the floor and drink it a cup of tea.
James has a bowl full of Nerf darts.
George looks out the window, the moon, it becomes a full moon, he turns into a werewolf and eats the other person.
Or he eats the other person, and halfway through eating the other person, he goes, eh, and then he just goes away from it. Let's see.
While eating, Randall reaches level 100 in Destiny or something.
While blindfolded.
He beats the raid. Solo.
Randall prestiges his meal.
Holding the controller backwards, he prestiges and platinums and...
Just like ages for different games that he hasn't even owned.
Craig has a plate of food in front of him, and he goes to eat it, and then they take it away to use the money for the food to pay for something on a Steam sale. let's see. Heather just jacks the waiter up. That's like, just knifes him in the neck. Let's see.
Heather's eating, and she throws coins on the floor.
Yeah, she throws coins on the phone. Everybody tries to pick them up, and then somebody dies. Let's see.
Jake reads a comic book, I guess.
No, Jake is. Jake says something like, "Yeah, sure, this meal is great," and is just passive aggressive throughout the whole thing. I choke on my food because I can't get through one sentence without swearing. So even when I'm eating, I'm swearing so much that it just, like, it goes down the wrong pipe and I end up choking.
You're so confused about the food, you just keep swearing the whole time.
And plus, since I never shut up, I'm just eating and eating and eating, and I'm talking, so I'm down to choke on something. let's see. Trevor eats his food on top of a ladder because that puts it, like, hand level to him. And Luke, let's see.
Is he in a banana?
No. The food's down for about a month, and then Luke comes in and says, "Hey, food," and then eats it and then walks out. So that's Luke. That's Luke. Love you guys. Love you. Right. You know what? I don't want to leave people out. A whole dinner is announced. Zach shows up for the dinner, says he wasn't invited to the dinner, and then bitches about the dinner. Okay, I think I got everybody now. I think I have everyone. Meerkat would eat the dinner, but oh, my glasses. So that's still my favorite one. That is still my favorite one. When we were playing Assassin's Creed and Meerkat always plays the cartographer. When he got killed, oh, my glasses.
Speaking of Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Effa just finished her, like, 4-month project.
Did she?
I think she announced on Twitter the other day that she finally finished editing it.
Oh, cool.
Let's not be too hasty. I think she might have finished an episode.
Okay. She finished the 30-second trailer.
The 30-second trailer, yeah. Everything is cut now.
Also, Heather and Assassin's Creed. A little video.
Promotion. My God, man. You're amazing. Yes, on youtube.com/teamdebaah. What did you see that debuted today?
Debuted today was Heather going after Jack the Ripper.
That's right. She's her new 5-part series just started today, which is the Jack the Ripper DLC for Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Heather, it's her series. You don't have to hear my dumbass voice running around as Jacob, complaining about the platforming. Forgetting to edit out parts like this fucking game. I can't fucking stand this game. I can't wait till this fucking game is over. So, see, shit like that does not get recorded. So.
My favorite episode of your Assassin's Creed adventures
was an episode where it was like, Heather, we now join Heather mid-fight because she, like, didn't record from the beginning.
Yeah.
And then she shut in a group of, like, 8 people killing them all.
Yeah, what had happened was Twitch didn't pick up the beginning of her stream. So, like, she's just like, Twitch cut off the beginning of the stream, and I said, I'll think of something. And that's what I thought of.
You're now trying Heather mid-fight. She's stabbing people.
That's what she does.
That's what she does. It's her thing. Like, meanwhile, across town, stab, 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 stab.
Yeah. I think it's nice for the Team DBAH channel to have like quite a variety in voices.
Yeah.
No offense, by the way. It can be taken the wrong way then.
Wow. Wow, what are you trying to say? God damn it.
Yeah, so now at the moment we've got Heather doing the Jack the Ripper DLC, and we've got Dave doing Doom.
You got Dave doing Doom, and Dave doing Doom. And pretty soon, you're going to see, we got 3 new series debuting this month. It's very exciting because yesterday was Jack the Ripper Part 1 from Heather. Next Friday is going to be Dark Souls 1 with Dave. That's the new series Dave is doing. And Tuesday, the 18th, a secret project, a labor of love between 2 of the members of Team DBAH. Actually, 2 of the members recorded and 2 other members actually contributed. It is the it's the biggest produced thing that we've done so far. Is a series that's starting up on the 18th, so stay tuned for that one.
Ooh, my curiosity has peaked.
Yeah. 2 people recorded parts from it, another person recorded the title card, and another person recorded the outro and did all the editing, so it's a true team effort. That one. So
some would say there's no hero when it comes to that video.
Oh my god, there's no I in hero. But there is sometimes when you spell hero, if it's a different country, sometimes hero is spelt with an I. Ah, shit.
Sometimes there's a me in team. Wait a minute.
There is. If you switch the words around a little bit. Or mate. Or meat. She thought it was funny.
I thought that one funny.
And he thought it was funny. But
so would you say it would be a good month to subscribe to the Team DBAH YouTube channel?
Holy shit, Jamie, it would be an amazing month to subscribe to the YouTube channel. The youtube.com/TeamDBAH. It would be an amazing month. Absolutely right. I haven't tried it yet, but I would love to share, because I've seen a lot of people streaming it. I just don't know if it's going to be allowed to be put up on YouTube, but I got to tell you, that Modern Warfare Remastered is worth that extra $20 they tack onto it.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, my God, it's beautiful. And it's such a walk down memory lane because... Oh, God, jeez, so beautiful. Oh, God, so beautiful. Just walking by Gaz in the beginning, it's like, all right, pick up that submachine gun and go over to range one and aim down range and he's talking, because I don't understand British people when they talk. Anyway, when he tells me to pick, I think to pick up a machine gun, but like looking at, you could tell like it's a different character model than everyone else. I'm like, holy crap! You're not just an ancillary background person. I mean, Modern Warfare was amazing when it came out, as far graphically, And to see it remastered, it's just, it looks incredible. And it plays just the same as last time. NPCs will still block your way. Like, especially on the tanker, when the guys are shooting down on you from the catwalks, and you just kind of want to get past the three guys that are, like, blocking the intersection in front of you to get to cover, still won't let you do it. Just like the old game. So I'm like, oh, this brings me back to the frustrating, like, just cacophony of swears I was throwing at the screen when I played this the first time. But also, like, it brought back, like, it brought back memories of, like, when my cousin Tony would play it downstairs in the basement, and when I the first time I actually saw the game in action, like, for realsies, as opposed to, like, seeing it on TV, and, like, the E3 specials and stuff, like, he was playing this game, and I'm like, holy sh, this is amazing. I mean, I had no interest in it, and just like, eh, it's all right. And then, like, I saw him play it, and I actually bought it myself. It was the first game I actually got killed in looking at a background texture.
Really?
Like, the mission where you have to defend the tank, there was a fire coming from a garbage can, and I spawned in, I turned around, I looked at it, and I went, damn, that fire is so realistic. And then, bang. Like... I should maybe play the game or kill those guys over there first. But yeah, it's beautiful. And I played the tanker level, and I played like the level right after it where you're going through the street on your way to your execution. You don't really play that, but you had very limited range of motion with your neck. Like, you could look kind of over here and, oh, I've already passed by this. You can look out the back window now, and you can see all the shit that's happening. And it's just, it's incredible. It takes you down memory lane, and it was good. It's a good incentive to spending that. It actually rationalizes spending that money, you know?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's good, then.
So... I was impressed with it.
Probably the smartest thing Call of Duty can do is just re-release the good ones.
Yeah. Well, Major Nelson announced that World at War was now backwards compatible.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Saw that.
And that was another great one that they did.
That'd be another one that'd be nice remastered.
Oh, yeah.
That was the first Zombies.
That was a good game.
If this does well... If the Modern Warfare Remastered does well, I definitely think they're going to be remastering other ones.
I mean, the Modern Warfare trilogy is actually a pretty good trilogy.
It's not bad. It's entertaining. It's solid.
Good story.
Yeah. The gameplay is just, it's smooth. It's one of the smoothest shooters, responsive, that I've ever really played. And
well, Modern Warfare was pretty much kind of the golden standard for FPSs on consoles for a while, wasn't it?
For a while, yeah. Yeah, it was.
I wonder how the level with Captain Price, where you're in like the ghillie suit and like crawling through the grass and you're sniping. That's gonna look good.
Oh god. That's gonna look amazing. Even the progression of, okay, Ghosts on the 360 looked good, but then there was that one level where you're crawling through the forest, and whenever you're going by a tree, it kind of just looked like, I don't know, someone cut out a piece of paper.
It's like being in South Park world.
Yeah. And I didn't get to that part in next gen consoles, but I was like, I mean, the dog, I gotta tell you, the standard by which because I played Ghosts on all four consoles, the standard by which I say, okay, the graphics have improved since last gen is whenever I look at the dog in the Humvee when you're coming back from the first mission. Cause he'll poke his head up and like look over at you. And I'm like, okay, I can see like, I can see his fur. I can see the scars that he has on his face. It's like, wow, this you didn't see back on last gen.
That was always the big thing with the dog, is they're like, look how scratched up the dog is.
Yeah, it's like, look how fucked up your dog is. I'm like, no, don't show me that. you gotta send out Riley to do something. No, I want to keep Riley. Send me.
You're just like, where's his leash? Someone get me his leash.
I was so pissed off in Ghosts, because especially when you meet up with the Ghost team and they're all in that auditorium and you got to free the one guy and the other people can play with the dog, but you can't.
Yep.
I was so pissed off. He was scratching his head. He was just like, you know, petting him and everything. I'm like, yeah, get your fucking hand off my dog. I want to do that.
Pet my dog.
That was the only good part of Assassin's Creed 3. I could pet the dogs. Try to do that.
Games where you could stroke dogs.
I want to pet them, right?
Yeah. I want that in the next Tomb Raider game. I want to be able to stroke the animals instead of kill them all the time.
Hey, gorilla! Come here. Are you Harambe?
Oh. Oh my.
I feel bad for anything now that has a gorilla in it, because it's immediately Harambe.
Exactly.
There was a trailer for RWBY Season 4.
Yeah, everyone's already calling that thing Harambe.
She fights a gorilla monster, and everyone's like, hey, look, it's Harambe.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that was like everyone's breakdown of the RWBY Volume 4 trailer was, man, RWBY fucked up Harambe.
other than the blatant Harambe killer, does everything else look good on RWBY?
Oh, it looks so much better.
Nice.
Yeah, it's like 10 times better than... Honestly, it looks 10 times better than Season 3 did, and Season 3 looked pretty good, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Grimm have, like, this new... Have, like, these effects to it now. They have, like, this black, wispy smoke coming off of them, and, like, trails, and, like, kind of, like, light trails coming out of their eyes.
Faded light.
Yeah, and everything looks much crisper, but I was also reading somewhere that they're not using Poser anymore.
It's a new program this year,
yeah. Yeah, they've switched from Poser to Maya, which is they've wanted to do for a while.
Yeah.
And I guess with the full screen money and all, they can actually do that now. So,
yeah. I believe the reason they didn't do it last year was because they wanted to be able to use the assets that Monty had worked on.
Right. Yeah, they were, and I guess with the longer break that they had between 3 and 4, they were able to get everything like kind of transferred over and everything.
I guess in a way it makes more sense, because it's like a more of a time jump this year than before.
Oh, there's a time jump too.
It's like about 6 months later.
Okay. So I was like, okay. I'm used to time jumps, like, you know, Whovian time jumps where it's like 12 years later and shit like that.
She's now the grandmother.
Yeah.
Whoa!
She's not like RWBY. RWBY MRA. She uses the sniper rifle more than the sickle now. Speaking of Rooster Teeth, we could potentially have some very good news, because Heather has entered us into the Extra Life stream. Not so much contest, but I guess they're doing. Two stream. They couldn't do the stream the original weekend of November 5th, or the 24-hour Extra Life charity stream that they do. So they're asking the Rooster Teeth community, basically, if you have a group, if you want to do an hour of the stream, and it's streamed also on the Rooster Teeth site. So we're going to actually we've been submitted and. We will keep our audience posted, but there's a good possibility that you might see Team DBAH on Rooster Teeth. Fingers crossed. Awesome. Fingers crossed. We might just be able to do this.
So So now Rooster Teeth is not going to do their 24-hour marathon?
They are going to do it. They are going to do it, but they're going to do it on the 12th.
Oh, okay, so they're just doing it a week later than what they did last year.
Yeah. They wanted to be able to do something on the week that, like, is traditionally the stream week. Right. But I guess logistics and everything like that, they couldn't get stuff nailed down or something to the effect, so they're reaching out to their community. Which I'm kind of happy for, because, to be completely honest, I haven't seen a lot of that lately. And it's cool that they're looking to the community to kind of help out with it. And I think that's pretty cool. And if we do get the opportunity, it would be great, because, I mean, that's basically how we, most 90% of us, met each other. So,
mm-hmm. Yep.
So it'd be kind of cool. And to get that kind of exposure, that would be awesome. But, you know. Not counting Hitchens before they catch. So, you know, just be nice. Positive energy and thoughts. I know that's really hard to direct towards us, but, you know. But aside from that, though, gotta tell you, James, I saw that you did a little bit of a paint job not too long ago.
Oh,
a certain thing.
Yes, I was able to pick up a Brute Spiker, the BOOMCO blaster from Toys R Us, and uh-huh. I gutted that thing the second I got it home.
Yikes!
And I kind of forgot where half of the stuff went, but you know what? It still actually works, even though I left half the parts out.
Wow!
But you know what? That's just a testament of how good I am with those things. But
you didn't even
use absolutely.
But yeah, I put a nice paint job on it to make it look more closer to the game. So nice. I'm pretty proud of it.
It looked fantastic.
Yeah. I was trying to get the coloring as close as I could, because some of the stock colors actually worked very well for it. Like mm-hmm. that kind of like I guess you could call it like kind of like that brownish, that very light tan that was on there worked really good, but I didn't want to just paint like the main red of it, and I'm like, I gotta figure out what else to do with it. So I did all like the blades a silver, and I just left that tan kind of like stock. So the two spikes on the bottom of it are silver, but the brackets that are holding onto it are still their stock colors. And it came out really nice.
Nice, nice.
I also put some nice silver dry brushing on it to make it look battle worn.
Yeah, I especially love around the barrel. Like just like how it looked kind of melted.
Yeah.
From extended use.
Yeah,
And then Craig, I'm sorry.
Oh, I was gonna say since we were talking about secret projects, I've actually started working on a project that will be announced at a later date on my channel that will have a tie into a certain series we do here on Team DBAH, with more information on that to come later.
See, so super secret.
Man, this is secret, a week secret. Of announcements.
We have a secret. That's from Mr. Roboto. That's a stick song.
Secret. That came out. I got a secret.
That came out when we were young, and we're turning 40 in a month.
Who's we?
Ah, damn it.
I'm talking to Craig. Craig. Yeah.
I blame Jamie.
I blame him too. It's easy to do it because he's.
No, it's Jamie. Not. I'm too lovable.
You are. Stop it. So, Craig, playing anything interesting lately?
Really, just the same stuff right now. I'm randomly doing Crucible in Destiny and playing The Witcher.
Have you found Dandelion?
No, but I did find Horsun.
Yes.
And, well, he's not alive anymore.
You know, so he wasn't alive in mine either. Yeah. We went straight up like Batman without the coat on that boy. It's like, you know,
just how Ben Affleck would have wanted it.
Just like Benny. He's putting Joe Manganiello there as a Deathstroke. That Ben Affleck is.
Probably gonna kill him too.
Yeah.
That'll be the end of the movie. We're like, Deathstroke, he just shoots him in the head.
Well, the on the Witcher front there, issue 2 of A Curse of Crows came out today. And they do this really awesome thing where they'll have like they incorporate side quests into it.
Oh, really? Huh.
Because they'll get someplace. They're on the way fighting what's called a Striga, and they're hunting it. But on their way, he's retelling. His flashbacks are basically from the first Witcher book from Andrzej Sapkowski, The Last Wish. And so the flashbacks are all shit from the book. And I'm like, when I was reading the first issue, I'm like, oh my God, this is exactly what happened. And he's in the same outfit he was in the first Witcher video game.
Oh.
And there's a cinematic where you see this guy running through a town from the first Witcher game, and then this monster coming down and devouring him, and then the Witcher coming out after he used this guy's bait, coming out there and fighting the beast itself. That's the Striga. And in this issue, they show him set the guy loose in the city.
Oh.
And then also, like, as they're walking, he's talking with Siri, and then something will happen in the background, and he'll talk to somebody, and essentially it's a side quest, because then you'll see, like, a page with different panels on it, and two of the panels is, like, conflict resolution of two or three of those things that went on, and then the story just keeps going. They did it in the first one, they did it in the second one, and it's really awesome. The only thing I can say bad about the book, and it's not bad, it's just that I would do things differently, is that the book is also following the Witcher canon. And in the Witcher canon, maybe he gets along with someone a little more intimately and a lot better than how my Geralt got along with someone. So maybe I might take umbrage with it. And I don't want to exactly say the spoiler about the episode or the issue, but it's not the option I'd go with, but whatever. However, I must say that Craig and I, we and Griever, we had a comic book come out this week that is truly a throwback to our youth.
We did?
We did, because He-Man Thundercats number 1 came out this week.
What?
Mm-hmm. It would appear that the great forces of evil have lost their faith in Mum-Ra and decided that the one thing that Mum-Ra could use to kill Lion-O and the rest of the Thundercats with was a sword from a far-off land of Eternia called the Sword of Power. And thusly, Thundera is brought into Eternia's orbit, and Mum-Ra stages a full-scale invasion on Eternia.
Huh.
Oh, wow.
There's more twists and turns in it. There's more violence in it. I don't know if DC, when they bought the rights, said, okay, everything you know about He-Man and Thundercats, screw it. We're going to fucking kill people. Because there's violence in this one.
That's what DC does.
The term pissed off is also in this one. Because the narrator says someone pissed off the Elder God. I'm like, that's something new. Don't remember that in Filmation.
He-Man, you really pissed him off.
You know, So I don't remember that. But you know what? it had a the person drawing it just knows how to draw what we saw as cartoons as a kid. Everything's just like completely muscle bound and swords and all that shit, and I'm like, wow. And the cameos in the background from all the different Masters of the Universe figures, some of which you always saw in the catalogs and you always saw in the toy commercials, but you were never able to find. Yeah, they were all in there. And it's got twists, it's got turns, and I enjoyed it.
Yeah. I'm going to have to find that.
Yeah, it was a very big surprise. First off, I didn't even know that it was supposed to be out until, like, last night when I was looking at the stuff, like, saying, okay, let me put things in the... Excuse me, I need to get some water. Hi, a little inside baseball. I use faucets. Yes. So, Team DBAH, not bottled water drinkers all the time. So take that. Hey, there's a television going on in the back room, and it's very loud, but, you know, hey, you can hear that, too. So, yeah, I don't record in a studio. We're not all together. Sorry to break the illusion.
I'm not even on this planet.
He's from Vorpulon over there. Oh, and by the way, another thing reference. It's probably not a reference, but I want to believe it's a reference because I need to find some good in it. In Destiny.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. So, New Monarchy has a shader, and I just unlocked it, and I freaked out when I saw it in the shader store, and I just unlocked it, so I'm doubly freaked out. It's called Amalthea. Now, this might reference some sort of mythology somewhere. This might reference some sort of literary figure somewhere, but what I hear... Or when I think of when I hear of Amalthea is the last unicorn, because when the unicorn turned into a human woman, they needed to give her a name and they named her Amalthea. So I am I'm just going with that. It's a reference to the last unicorn, and nobody can tell me different.
So Sean, you can be a unicorn if you want to be a unicorn.
Shut up. Do you know how much I get that shit even from like you people? And I don't mean British people. I mean everybody. People. I'm glad you clarified it. I didn't mean just British. I mean everybody in this group.
What do you mean?
With the Charlie Team DBAH. What do you mean team? Well, you got me there. I'm sorry. Terribly racist.
What do you mean racist?
Oh, no.
This hole's getting deeper.
Yes, it is. Oh my god.
Speaking of holes.
Wow. Okay. Oh, wow. This can go any number of ways, but go on, Jamie. Randall, by the way, Randall, it's 59:48. Go on.
Oh. Actually, what I have to say it has nothing to do with holes. It's just
you just wanted to say holes.
Yeah, maybe. I'm just thinking of holes. Donuts. Other holes, but DC not too long ago.
Yes.
By not too long ago, I mean a couple of hours ago. Released.
That's not too long ago.
It is. I'm very literal.
Very.
But they did an announcement for Suicide Squad Extended Edition.
What?
Yep. They're going 2 for 2 now.
So is this going to have all the Joker shit that was left out that Jared Leto said probably after he dies they'd put it in?
Probably.
Oh, God, Jared Leto's going to die.
Somebody go check on him.
That's great. Okay, I didn't see it in the theaters. Maybe there's a reason I didn't see it in the theaters. Maybe this new extended edition is going to be like the primo stuff.
So what it seems if a DC movie does bad, they'll just put a load more on it, release it as a normal DVD, release it normally, and hopefully people will like it more.
Yeah, maybe. I watched Batman v Superman, and it's just shit, but still.
It's that, and then apparently adding another 30 minutes to it makes it better?
Question mark?
Trepidatious? Question mark.
It's like, there's so much going on in Suicide Squad, I don't know what more they can put in it.
Well, apparently they found some stuff that they could.
Well, they left almost an entire Joker movie on the cutting room floor, apparently, with the amount of Jared Leto that they took out of it. So maybe they'll put more in and everybody will be happy, because as much as people bitched about the Joker, they also said that Jared Leto was awesome as a Joker. So
he's a great Joker. He was just very underused.
Right.
So maybe that's what they're hoping. They're hoping if they just... So I don't know what that's going to do to the movie. I don't know if the movie's just going to be Suicide Squad doing stuff and then cut to the Joker cutting some guy to pieces or something.
Oh my god, that's horrible. Just like using a giant novelty Cuisinart.
But yeah, I kind of see where you're going with that one, because it's going to be like... Is it going to be like two movies squished into one now type of thing?
Yeah. I mean...
That's true.
I mean, the Joker material left in the movie does very loosely fit in with the Suicide Squad story.
Okay.
Huh. I mean, you mostly just... Mostly, like, you just see him, like, kind of just show up at times. Like, I guess...
The Joker! Stuff
that... Which is kind of a Joker thing.
Yeah.
Like, they do a very... They do, like, something that I saw in Batman... Is it Attack on Arkham or something?
Assault on Arkham.
Assault on Arkham.
Arkham. Sorry.
But in it, they have this whole thing where Joker dies in a plane crash or a helicopter crash, and then shows up alive. Hmm. Now, that's kind of a Joker thing, and they do that thing in Suicide Squad, which is also pretty Jokerish. It's pretty. It's those kind of little things that are you like, oh, that plays out. Like, you never believe they'd kill Joker in a helicopter crash off screen.
Well, I'll tell you this much.
Oh.
The first time you quote-unquote ever see the Joker die in the comic book was back in, I believe, 87 in Death of the Family, or Death in the Family, where everybody, they put two numbers in the back of a comic book, and it was a hotline. And if you called one number, you voted for Jason Todd to die. If you called another number, you voted for Jason Todd to live. And he was voted to die by a landslide. But at the end of that story arc, the Joker got away from being arrested and prosecuted by killing Robin because, get this, in the 80s were a very different time. The Joker became an ambassador to Iraq or Iran, whichever one had the Ayatollah Khomeini in it, because he was in the comic. And he was in Iran, thank you. I'm very bad at geography, but I don't want to offend anyone. But he became an ambassador to Iran, so he had diplomatic immunity.
Oh, wow. Diplomatic immunity.
Has just been revoked. And he was... He was in a helicopter because he was going to Smilex gas the UN, and he was in a helicopter, and one of the guys had a machine gun, and one of his henchmen had a machine gun, and Batman, like, I guess threw a batarang or whatever, and was on the helicopter, and he got shot in the arm or something, and he kicked the guy with the machine gun. The machine gun guy shot the Joker in the chest, and then the entire helicopter went down and crashed. So apparently he quote-unquote died in that. So,
it's crazy. See, it doesn't get that intense in Suicide Squad. In Suicide Squad, that helicopter just goes down. I think it's shot by a missile. It's no Iran. No.
There's no Iran Contra affair. No, nothing.
Yeah. Maybe in the sequel.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, in Assault on Arkham, he shot down by what? Deadshot, right?
I think so.
More like Dead shoots down the helicopter. Yeah.
He just sort of like falls, crashes, and then kind of back at some point. That's the Joker's known to do.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So, I don't know if it's going to be a thing with DC now, that they're just going to release a movie in the theaters and then release the better movie later on. Well,
did you hear what Ben Affleck's new Batman movie title is going to be?
Yes.
It's very creative. Are you ready?
Very. Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's called The Batman.
Oh, my God.
Wouldn't have guessed it.
The amount of man hours that probably went into picking that is probably mind-boggling.
Randall, I'm going to need some klaxons. As soon as he comes in. Thank you. Thank you. Always there for me.
Now I'm probably going to have to edit that.
No, no, that's fine. That's fine. I like that. I like that.
Well, I just mean the volume.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh. I'll
raise it up.
Raise it up.
Gonna go full klaxon on this.
Hmm.
So, on that note, is there anything else anybody has to add for this week?
What did I don't know, but you may have gotten a free copy of Gears of War.
I might have done that. Yeah. I might. It might be 29% done on my Xbox right now.
Oh,
this is a possibility. By next podcast, we will know if this indeed.
Or if you'll need to be Craig to play it.
My we'll find God. Out.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
From the abridged.
Ka me me
I used to get back.
Callbacks. Anyway, I'd like to thank Craig for being here tonight.
Yeah, thank you for always being you.
Thank you. And I'd like to thank James for being here tonight. James, why don't you plug your YouTube channel?
Hey, YouTube.com/TheGriever2112.
I'll plug your YouTube channel.
Whoa. Oh my wow. God. Ooh, sassy. You can yeah, also catch cool
and dirty in one shot.
You can also wow. Catch James as the frontman of Team Dad Jokes probably next month or so when the new season of Team Dad Jokes premieres. So get ready for that with a brand new member. Who could it be? Oh, I think it's me. Also, I'd like to thank Jamie for being here tonight. Thank you very much, man.
Thank you for allowing me to speak some stuff.
You can speak some stuff whenever you want to on this podcast. And I want to say thank you for Randall for the edits and for making this podcast wonderful. Thank you, man.
No problem.
All right. And remember, swing by TeamDBAH.com for everything that is TeamDBAH, including this very podcast that comes out every Thursday that's available on Stitcher, SoundCloud, iTunes, and Player FM. By checking out our pull list that comes out every Wednesday where Jake and I tell you what comic books you should be reading for the week. And, of course, we have a monthly Loot Crate review from Jamie. One actually just went up this week for the Speed Crate, correct?
Speed, yep. It's speed, a good one.
Yes, it is a good one. So check those out. Remember, at youtube.com/TeamDBAH, you get a brand new video 7 days a week. And Craig, who brings us? Who sponsors us?
The lovely folks at noscopeglasses.com. If you click the link in our podcast description or on our website, you can get a pair of fancy gaming glasses or computer glasses. To relieve the stress on your eyes, and you help out the show as well.
See, it's a win-win situation for everyone.
It is.
See the games, so, get the kills, get the achievements.
There you go.
Oh my God! You are killing it this week with the
there
advertising.
There you go.
All that money.
That money, dough. Money and dough. Oh my God. Oh. I gotta stop before. Just somebody stop me. I'm gonna be the one who stops me. I'm stopping. Anyway, thank you for listening, folks. I've been Charlie Danger 82. This has been the official Team DBAH podcast number 161.
Yep.
We'll see you next week. We'll see you next week. And please remember, don't be a hero. Good night.
far we have.
Let's see.
Okay, I'm a little impressed with theirs. They're not color coordinated, though.
They're not color coordinated, but damn, they did look pretty schnazzy. Why the fuck do they keep starting this down here? Down here is death.
Yeah, it is.
Only if you permit it.
Hey, I got one!
Oh, for...
Nice party bomb.
Yeah, it wasn't my intent.
Ah, damn it.
Gonna try to get him up. There.
Down.
All enemies down. Nice. All
enemies have... Holy shit.
Oh, and they're all part of the same group. You think this is one of those, yeah, let's bait them in with a little more confidence and then we just wreck them?
I don't know how. That could be.
More than likely. You know how these leetsters think. They just want to break you in every sense of the word.
Wait, where are they?
Don't know. Oh, they're back here. They're back here. They're back here.
They're in the hall. They're trying to go into the train tunnel, I think.
Guardian down. Damn it.
Oh. Okay.
They're beating flanking. Us in.
Well.
Behind you, George. Oh!
You're learning. Got one of them.
How did you die, Charlie?
What's that?
He got
How did
flanked.
You die?
I got flanked.
Well, at least you didn't get beef-franked. Go for it,
Guardian. You're tied. You got flank steak.
Get it? Hot dog bun? Bun joke?
I see what you did there. I see what you did.
You just don't want me to do it again?
No, I don't.
Okay, two of them over here by the tunnels. Okay.
Alright. Graver, are you with...
Wow.
Nope. No, you're not.
Bag, really?
You are not with me. Did they teabag?
I'm behind you.
Alright, hold on.
Wow, they teabagged you? That's fucked up.
Yeah, they did. They're both in here. I don't know where the third one is. He's probably gonna come behind you at some point.
Damn it.
Damn it.
Don't let this be the end. Fight on. That didn't teabag me. Hey guys, we all have one death. Look at that. We're all equal. What's
a few points between you and Victor? I think we should report that teabagger for unsportsmanlike conduct.
That's fine. I'm not above doing that. I don't.
Crap, I got don't. Stuck.
That's fine.
Okay, I didn't die.
You're okay. Right. You're okay. Come on.
Oh. Watch your back. Watch your back. Crap.
Damn it, I got stuck.
Ah, he met up with the others.
Oh, RXG, the beast, you're getting reported.
Why, what'd he do?
He teabagged.
Heavy ammo inbound.
I'd report him right now, but God knows I don't want to be reported, get kicked again for being away from our console for 2 minutes.
No worry, I put a report on him.
Good. Wow.
They picked up their
heavy. That's something.
Freaking course. Wow, couldn't even land a freaking smack on his heel. You will come back from this death. It's what guardians do. So why are we doing this again?
This is match point. Yearbook.
Last chance. Penny, right.
The Penny's wish book.
Because we hate ourselves.
Damn it.
Damn it.
There you go. Nice.
Oh.
Oh, he did a thing.
Yeah. Come back stronger. And I don't know why I wasn't able to pick up Griever.
Countdown timer.
I guess not.
Two red dots. Ah.
Yay,
passion coins!
Yay, exotic helmet. Passage watch, coins. It's gonna give me a hunter next.
Oh, at least you got an exotic drop. I didn't get shit. All my brief coins gotten.
Yeah, passage coin.
Oh, but I just need one more kill with my teammates alive for that bounty. And four more revives.
Let me see. I need one more revive. And two more kills with teammates alive. You know, fire team gonna... kill streak. It's funny.
I think I'm gonna hang back and see if you guys need help with stuff, and then pick you up if you fall.
Helping hand.
Yeah.
Oh. See, if we're grouped, we all get killed quickly, and then we can just go on to the next game.
Sounds like somebody wants to do it quick and dirty.
God, yes. I don't care about this game. I just want to look cool. Ask me if I like Destiny.
Do you like Destiny?
God, no. But still, it's something fun to play with you guys, even though I just spent $30 for reskinned just complete crap, but still, I enjoy playing with you guys, so of course I'm going to play this with you.
Son of a gun. Stand up. Sliding all over the place, not even really...
At least they're not teabagging.
Not yet.
Sorry.
Points between you and victory. Onwards. Let's see.
I have no idea.
Get into the bottom. I'm gonna sneak up on them. Well, hey, you got your wish. At least we're not starting down here.
Guardian down. Damn it.
Oh man. I almost got him. But not quiet. We will come back from this death. It's what guardians do. Is that what guardians do? Coming back from death?
Hey Charlie, two of them are blue.
What? I
believe in you, guardians. They're blue, da boo dee bo da da da.
Oh boy, now I just kinda hope we lose. Guardian down.
Picked off by mother freaking.
Who died? Like we were both oh, you weren't with us. Okay. Alright.
Well, I found two of them, so there's that.
How is that possible? We found two of them. Heavy ammo on the way. I think they're cheating.
A bunch of them. God damn it.
This is why I like being close to you. They aim for the dangerous one first, so I die quicker.
I couldn't even get a freaking headshot in. Might have multi-tool is a bullcrap gun.
It's not that bullcrap, I'm using it and I can't hit shit.
I'm waiting for that automatic rifle that you guys were talking about, the one with the only one with the match point. Time for a comeback. Elemental effect. Yeah, that's what I'm waiting for.
God damn it.
Oh, these guys are good. Completed trials passage, guys!
Yeah. Yay!